Hello, wifey.
Hey, Bobby.
Oh my God, babe, this is from work. How did they even get to know this number? Well, oh my God, I've been commissioned. 250 million naira sitting in my bank account.
Babe, your big break is officially here.
Oh, I beg you, this guy. What big break are you talking
it
about?
Is.
Come on. How much is our money from that? It's just 10%, 25 million. That is not enough for us to be on the list of billionaires.
You see why I married you? You see with the eyes of an eagle.
Maybe, and thanks for coming on this journey with me.
We'll ride and die together forever.
Yeah. Ride and die together forever. Oh, wait, they just told me that I should come pick up my car tomorrow morning.
Wait, this company treats you like a king, babe.
What do you think I am, baby? Your baby has a truck full of values. That's what your baby is. Yeah.
You make arrogance sound so sexy, Desmond. This calls for celebration. I should go get us something.
Make sure it's just 2% alcohol or less.
Okay.
I don't want us getting drunk.
Are you trying to insinuate anything?
No, I'm not insinuating. You know what? Just don't go.
They could start giving instructions.
No, no one is going to do that.
Yes,
would do that. Come on. They know that I am on my honeymoon, okay? So no one is going to do that. And I made a promise to you that I'm going to spend 1 week with you, no instructions.
Yeah, bro, you're leaving me already.
Come on.
Hey. We're outside.
You're outside. What do I care?
People are watching.
And let them see that I love my wife so much. Now tell me you love me.
But you know I do.
Tell me you love me.
I love you.
Babe.
Okay, come and go.
Oh, now you're driving me.
No, I'm not.
You're driving me. Okay.
All right, babe. Have a nice day. Yeah.
Supervisor.
Wait, Darry Peters? Come in.
Okay.
What, you mean you don't remember me? National Indigenous Arts Exhibition, Abuja, 2021.
Emerald. You are?
Yes.
You are that crazy lady that almost beat up the director of the event.
Okay, now you're exaggerating. Please sit.
Thank you.
Sit down.
I guess the old man will think otherwise because he was as chill as ice throughout the rest of the show.
Well, he got what he deserved. I mean, I get the fact you're trying to give your own people jobs, but at least give it to the ones that know what they're doing. You get me, right?
I do. And that is why, as frightened as I was, I had to support your little rebellion.
And I never got to say thank you for that support. So this is me saying thank you.
No issues, no issues. It was fun while it lasted.
Yes, it was. It was really fun.
I supervised the estate, yeah.
That's nice.
Yes. I was not around yesterday, so I sent in my assistant to settle you in. I hope everything is as you expected.
Yes, yes, it is. No. I forgot. The AC in the master's bedroom is not functioning properly. It's not chilling just like the ones in the other room.
Okay. Can I take a look?
Yeah, sure. I'll show you. All right,
after you.
Mr. Darry, it's really good to see you. I'm not doubting you, but whatever you did seems pretty easy and simple to be very effective.
Well, sometimes easy and simple can be effective.
Tell me though, how did you go from being an artist to an estate supervisor and a technician?
Well, I am not a technician, and I just try to possess a little knowledge about everything. As for being an artist, it's just a gig I engage in from time to time.
For me, art is life.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing else I would love to do apart from art.
Well, that reminds me. I remember you teach arts to some group of teens at Abuja. How's that going?
That was when I paid a short visit to my father's foundation. I've moved past that now.
Mm.
Dabbled into other things like real estate, stuff like that.
Well, I see. And bidding, I see.
I really can't match your energy.
Coming from someone who just fixed my AC. I mean, the air is cooling faster than normal.
So I was right.
I guess you were. So have you had anything to eat? There's no cooked food in the house, but I could fix you something. Noodles and egg.
No. I really couldn't stress you like that. I'm fine.
Oh, come on. You don't have to be modest. It won't take time. And just so you know, my noodles are to die for.
All right, you win.
Okay.
You win.
So
you
that's
win.
A yes.
That's a yes.
All right, pick this up.
You make him sound like an angel.
He is an angel. He saved me when my whole life was falling apart. I lost my dad, and everything was just going wrong. And he came into my life at the perfect time.
Your dad died?
Mm.
I am so sorry.
It's okay, but I'm in a better place now. I've moved past it, and I'm married to the most wonderful man in the world.
And enjoying some honey in the moon. I really can't wait to make his acquaintance.
Sure, you will very soon. We're staying here for 6 months.
Okay.
He has this contract he's doing with the state government. He's an architect and a civil engineer.
And an amazing husband.
Sure, he is.
I know this is water, but a toast to him.
Hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Well, this works for me. I have the desire to drink, but I guess God forgot to give me the head to carry it. So this is good.
Okay. I think I'm done here. So?
None.
I will just wash the plate.
Hell no, that's not happening. Just leave it that. I'll clear that. It's fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I set out to give hospitality and that I ended up getting one.
It's shocking, right?
Shocking.
And I'm glad you enjoyed my noodles. I told you.
Wonderful. It was just as you said. It was me. Thank you.
You're welcome. I'll see you off when you're done.
Not.
Okay.
All right.
Babe, you don't have to swallow everything Swanky says hook, line, and sinker. He might be an investment banker, but he gives the worst finance advices ever.
Come on, babe. He took me through the maths, and I must say that the returns are mind-blowing, babe.
It's illegal.
Illegal. Illegal things are where you find the mine, the gold mine. I will not be involved. Okay? I'm going to be a silent investor.
Hey. I know you want to be a billionaire, okay? And I know you will be, because I trust you. Your passion, patience, and your ambition will get us there, but nothing illegal.
You know, you turn me on when you fire.
Okay, better. Fire yourself down, because we are not abandoning this today. Not again. We have to finish this.
Hey, are you trying to say that a romantic dinner before our first night was not a perfect idea?
Our first night?
Yeah, first night as husband and wife.
Oh.
You know, that's different.
I didn't notice. Babe, guess what?
What?
The estate supervisor is someone I know. How exciting can that be?
Really?
Yeah.
Girl or a guy?
A guy. So we worked on this arts exhibition some time ago. It was a 7-day packed arts exhibition, a lot of activities, and it was jam-packed and it was really good. We were actually on the board. That took care of the external team. And we really got along quite well then.
And did you keep in touch after the exhibition?
No, which is why I was so surprised and excited at the same time seeing him here. And he helps fix the AC. Didn't you notice the room is cooler than yesterday?
It was in our bedroom.
To fix the AC, I thought I just mentioned that. Desmond, where are you going to? Is he living? God, are you okay? Oh my God. So sorry. Oh, come. Let me help. So sorry. Easy.
Jesus, like, is this one?
Oh, come. Let me look at it. I'll take a look at it. Oh. Easy. Just try.
Okay.
Yeah. Easy. Oh, sorry. So sorry. Why aren't you looking or what? Don't worry, I'll help you. Babe, come on. I'll help you.
I'm okay.
I have to take a look at it. You're not okay. You see? Oh, you see? Let me have a look at it. Let me see. This one. Oh, babe, how did you trip? Weren't you looking at where you were going to?
Okay, now scold me now, mommy. Oh,
my God. But wait, what's with this attitude? We were cool a few minutes ago.
A few minutes ago? Okay. Ah, okay, this is a knock on the door. Okay.
Would you just let me?
Hmm?
Because if this bone doesn't go back to its previous location, it will hurt even more.
Mm-hmm.
So relax. Come in! Hey. Good evening, Mr. Darry.
I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
No.
Okay. Earlier this morning, I forgot to give you a copy of our house rules to sign. The manager just asked for it.
Oh, okay. I'll go through it and sign right in.
It's all right.
Meet my husband.
Pleased to make your acquaintance, sir. Your wife has told me lots of beautiful things about you.
Maybe you should accord me a sir. Accord the same respect to my wife. Supervisor.
Can you stop being stubborn?
Are you alright, sir?
I'm fine, supervisor.
He's not. He sprained his ankle.
I could help.
I don't remember asking for your help, supervisor. Oh, caretaker.
I'll go through this and I'll sign it. Babe, your feet is not okay. I'll go through this.
It's right here.
Okay.
Here's a pen.
Okay, I'll quickly go through if I sign. Do I have to sign this one as well?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Right here.
Okay. I think that's all. Okay.
Alright.
There you go.
Thank you. Let me do this. Thank you again.
Thank you. You surprise me.
No, you surprise me. The whole point of me having time to ourselves is to actually have time to ourselves and not get a third party get involved in that moment.
So when I opened the door and found out it was someone I knew, I should have slammed the door on his face.
I didn't say that.
Then what are you saying? Because you're getting me confused.
Barely 48 hours since we got married. And I don't want to fight you.
And you think I want to fight?
I'm sorry. Hey, baby. Are you just going to stay like that? Huh? Staring at the man, the husband, that you sworn in front of everyone that you're going to love and cherish in madness and insanity? Huh? Hey.
And you think that I got married to you to jump out the window when the storm hits? No, man. You are stuck with me. We're in this together, okay?
I don't want to break us. Never.
You're stuck with me, man, okay? So, do you want me to massage your ankle or you want to keep limping around?
Oh my God, I saw you yesterday with this pretty lady, but I couldn't stop by because I was in a hurry. Oh my God, I can't believe I'm seeing you again. Oh God, I've really been praying to meet you again.
Yeah?
Yes. No jokes, Desmond. You know, you're one of the few good guys I met back then, and I was really a fool. Anyways, what are you doing in Lagos?
Work.
Yeah, I'm also here for a job. You know, we have this hush-hush project by the federal government, so I... Desmond, I have this project from the state government, and it's a huge project, you know? And so I'm around for now. You know, there's this project we have from the federal government. We named it the Project C to control exposition. You know how the public can be. You were lost in thoughts. Where were you?
I'm just thinking about work. No.
You know what? I can't believe our 1 week it's over. I'll miss you every day.
I will be close by.
Come eat before you go late to your work on your first day. Babe. The kitchen sink is clogged again.
Oh, you need me to help you with it?
No. Dario will come fix it. He'll come with a plumber. I think something needs to be fixed because I don't know why it keeps clogging.
He seems to be everywhere, isn't he?
Okay. I'll advise you stop this right there before this results into what both of us would like. Let's eat, please. You're back home early. Desmond. Are you being serious right now? Between both of us, we're supposed to be sulking. Oh, please.
I nearly killed a pregnant lady today.
Oh my God. What?
As I was driving to the site, this pregnant lady came out of nowhere. And my brake almost failed. But the good thing is that I didn't hit her. It was so close. So close that she went into premature labor. So I had to drive her to the hospital and wait till her husband got there.
Oh my God. Is she okay?
Yes. She's okay. But she lost the baby.
Jesus. Jesus. Is she pressing charges?
Fortunately, no. But it turned out that she has been having complications before the accident.
Thank God, but I'm obviously pained at what happened at the child, but I'm just thinking, what if this was a serious case? What if it turned out to be a serious one?
I was terrified. I was confused. I was lost. I have never been involved in a car accident before.
It's okay. It's okay.
Talk this over to someone.
Look, I understand it. It's okay.
It was scary. It was scary.
Coming.
Hello. I'm Rita. I'm friends with Desmond. Thank you. Is he okay? I didn't see him at the site today.
You work together?
Yes. And whenever still. I stay next door.
Oh, I see.
So, is he okay? Because I was pretty worried he didn't show up at the site. And Desmond is not someone that jokes with responsibility.
I can see you know him pretty well.
Let's say we grew up together. Almost like it. We're friends right from teenage.
So you lived in Port Harcourt?
Still lives. I'm just here for work.
I see. Well, my husband is not feeling too well. But he'll surely return to work tomorrow.
Your husband?
Yeah, but he'll definitely return to work tomorrow.
Did you know he was married?
He didn't tell you?
We've not had time for proper conversation. Please, just tell him I checked on him.
Sure, I will.
All right, bye.
Hey.
So the underground elevator does not go through the common room. It opens in the alley, you know, which was the initial plan. But the new changes is going to affect the placement of the elevator. Yes. I'm on it right now. So I'm going to get back to it and I'll call you. Okay, sir. All right. Hey, babe. Is food ready? Because I'm drained.
Rita was here.
Rita? What did she say she wanted?
She came to check up on you because you didn't show up at work today.
Oh, yes, work. That's nice. We work together. She's an engineer.
And she's our neighbor. Your long-time friend. You never mentioned any of that.
Because it's irrelevant. She's not important.
But I told you about Dari. Why didn't you mention it?
Because Dari. And look how nicely that turned out. To think that I almost killed someone today because I left home hungry.
So would you prefer it if I'm being this honest with you in this marriage?
I don't know. I don't know. Okay? I don't know what you prefer. Gosh. Isn't it too early for this drama? Huh? Rita is irrelevant. She's not important. And she doesn't deserve to be a topic of discussion.
If she's not relevant, why didn't you mention it? Is that simple?
I don't even know what's wrong with you. Like, I mean, oh!
It's me deeper than I thought. Messing with my thoughts and energy. Everything I did for you. You should know I love you every morning. Hope you don't see that I am broken. Yes, I'm a broken man. I woke up every morning trying to hide my flaws. It thought me into someone I don't recognize. I'm not a monster, I'm just broken and exhausted. Can't you see? Ooh, ooh, ooh. Somebody save me from bad energy. Somebody save me.
So we now sleep in separate bedrooms. I'm sorry your walk got ruined, but I would not apologize for something I know nothing about.
Mommy, I'll just go away. I need some space to clear my head, please.
Go to hell, Desmond. Go to hell and clear your head from there. You suck all what?
Could love you still, but it's obvious I still need some healing. So would you stay? Take mine, be the so would you stay, take mine and help me. I thought I was safe from this, I thought I was free from this. I'm a prisoner of my past. I thought I could love you still, I thought I could be the one. But it's obvious I still need some healing. So would you stay, take mine, be the one. So would you stay, take mine, and help me heal you? Ooh, ooh, ooh. Somebody save me from bad energy. Somebody save me, somebody save me. Somebody save me from bad energy. Somebody save me. Somebody save me.
Somebody save me from bad energy. Somebody save me. Somebody save me.
Isn't it too early for this drama? Huh? Rita is irrelevant. She's not important. And she doesn't deserve to be a topic of discussion.
Mommy, I'll just go away. I need some space to clear my head.
No one gave me a heads up that marriage would be stressful.
Thanks. We dated for 2 years.
So what is the problem? Why are we acting like two strangers?
I don't know. I don't know what's happening, honestly.
Did something happen at work today?
I got to site today and everything went south. They agreed portion of land for the lodges are now perfect for the garden. Meanwhile,
all the sketches that they were referring to be suitable are the most ridiculous thing I've ever seen in my entire world, in all my life as an architect. And everyone in this architectural world knows the natural environment are hindrances, and the effect can be can actually affect the air, heat, and
relax. Look, everything will be fine, I promise. They flew you all the way from Abuja to Lagos because they believe in your ability. So relax. These things happen.
I don't know. To make me feel like a fool today. I look like a fool today. And it's like any time we fight. I mean, I fight you, my day falls apart.
Babe, you don't have to go superstitious right now. You don't need that. These things happen, I told you. Everything will be fine, I promise, okay? You know what we're going to do? We'll go inside while you get a shower, eat, relax, rest. I mean, rest your head. And you start tomorrow on a clearer note. At least you have a clearer head and state of mind.
Thank you.
So, let's go. Come on.
You should be a lady and take your husband back.
Ow. You got me right there. Gladly. Let's go. Okay. Thank you, and I'll try not to clog it again.
You're welcome.
How about lunch? Look, no matter what you say, I must treat you to my delicious rice and sauce. It's very, very nice. You can't say no to that. It's my way of showing gratitude.
Emerald, why can't I shake off this feeling that you are being extra nice over what's in the past?
Well, you're correct. A bit of me still feels this guilt that what I initiated made the organizers seize everyone's balance. But just so you know, young man, I am extremely extra nice. It's in my nature to be that way.
You're right. You took up that fight even though it wasn't yours in the first place. It had to take someone extra nice to do that.
Correct. So, yes to my rice and sauce.
You
can't
said...
say no to that.
Okay. I don't have a choice.
No, you don't.
Okay. I think I'll just wait for you.
All right. I'll be really sure.
You were right. It tasted incredible.
I told you. No. You're not doing that, mister. You're my guest, so it's my treat. Yes.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
I'll be right back.
Welcome, sir.
Hey, babe. Welcome home. Daddy here helped me fix the clogged sink. Mm-hmm.
hope I didn't put you in any kind of trouble.
Not at all. How? Am I a baby?
Yes. Technically, you are your husband's baby, so it is okay if he's a little overprotective.
What's going on here? Is this man protecting men?
I think I have to take my leave now.
Yeah, sure. I'll see you. It's okay.
Thank you.
Thank you once again.
Thank you for the meal.
Bye.
Bye.
You know, jealousy looks ridiculous on you.
Thank you. Any more insult?
Are you trying to pick up a fight?
Please, listen to me. Just let me be, okay? Or better still, maybe you can go backstairs and clog that sink some more so your jobless friend could come help you fix it.
Look, I will not be part of whatever madness it is you're dealing with. Deal with it! I won't be dragged into it!
Madness, you are the one that are going through madness. You're talking about madness. You are going to... Ah! Oh,
God. Are you okay?
Now get away from me!
She's our neighbor. Your long-time friend. You never mentioned any of that.
Because it's irrelevant. She's not important.
You know, jealousy looks ridiculous on you. Are you okay?
Get away from me!
I swear.
A peace is impossible to have.
I don't think so. I think if we both honestly want peace, we can make it work. It's going to take a lot of time, but if one is really serious about it and put in the work, it will work.
Yes, pretty. Smart.
And you are one affectionate lover.
best, Mom. Good morning.
You don't look good.
I don't feel good at all.
I guess work is getting tougher, huh?
Not that. You know, work doesn't get tough for me. It's just that I didn't treat malaria when I should have, so it hits pretty hard.
Well, I guess some things never change. You never rest until your body forces you to.
You are wrong. A lot has changed, though. Mm. It's just that, you know, I don't even get too excited to finish a project before I breathe.
And here you are.
This is different. The week preceding this, I came here, was very busy for me.
Oh, I see. That's the exact week that I got married, you know?
I didn't get to say congratulations. Yeah. Congratulations.
Yeah, sure. Thank you. So?
I've called the chief engineer, but can you do me a favor? Just help me check everything is going fine, please.
Don't worry. I will tell him how terrible you are.
No, don't make it sound that bad. It's not that horrible.
Well, I will tell him how horrible you are, because I won't be lying.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right, don't worry.
Have a great day.
All right, thank you.
Yeah, bye.
Tell me you've been bent on this thing the whole day. Huh? Come on. I brought you on this vacation to relax. Okay? On a 6-month vacation. When I work.
How did your day go today?
Baby, this is not the mood I left you with. So now you are going to tell me what is bothering you. So now, spill. What's wrong?
That lady, Rita, you said she's nothing to worry about.
Yes, I said it. That she's nothing to worry about. But why are you raising this up now?
I saw both of you this morning.
Are you spying on me now?
Hey, why would you say a thing like that? The intention was to watch my darling husband leave for work, just like every other happy wife would.
Okay. All right, fine. So she was sick, and then she came to me today so I can help talk to her boss. That's all.
Is she your ex-girlfriend?
This is some kind of interview or something.
Just answer the damn question, Desmond. Is Rita your ex-girlfriend?
Now I know that you're crazy.
Excuse you?
Oh, Christ! Jesus Christ!
I'm sorry, can I?
You're a witch! That's what you are! You are a fucking witch! That anytime we have a fight, like, something bad happens to me.
Are you calling me a witch?
I am not calling you a witch. I'm asking if you are one.
You are mad. You are a madman.
You are mad.
Stupid man.
No, you are stupid.
You are mad.
You are a witch. Thank you.
It's me deeper than I thought. Messing with my thoughts and energy. Everything I did, I had it for. You should know I love you every morning. Hope you don't see that I am broken. Yes, I'm a broken man. I woke up every morning trying to hide my flaws. I thought me into someone I don't recognize. I'm not a monster, I'm just broken and exhausted. Can't you see? Somebody save me from bad energy. Somebody save me. Somebody save me. Somebody save me from bad energy. Somebody save me. Somebody save me. I thought I was safe from this. I thought I was free from this. I'm a prisoner of my past. I thought I could be the one. I thought I could love you still. But it's obvious I still need some healing. So would you stay? Take mine. Be the So would you stay? Take mine and help me. I thought I was safe from this. I thought I was free from this. I'm a prisoner of my past. I thought I could love you still. I thought I could be the one. But it's obvious I still need some healing. So would you stay? Take mine. Be the one. So would you stay, take mine, and help me heal?
Hello? What? Oh my God, I'm coming there straight away. I'm coming, I'm on my way. Yes!
Said nothing happened.
So what? What happened? How did it happen?
I don't know. Especially the tractor. All the machines are always serviced every night, every evening at the work.
No. It felt like it was kept on automobile. And I don't know, all of a sudden, I was just under it.
Do you think this has got anything to do with what you accused me of yesterday? About being a witch?
No, I don't know if it has got something to do with it. See, you know what? I don't know what's going on, actually.
Have you given this a thought? And you might just be the person trying to connect unrelated incidents together. It might just be in your head.
Not when it happens repeatedly. Like every single time we fight. Like every damn time. You know, and when we are okay, it's like I am on a winning streak. Like everything moves smoothly for me.
I still can't make sense out of what you're saying. It doesn't make sense to me. But one thing I can assure you, babe, is I am not a witch.
I know. I know that you're not a witch. I was just angry. Feeling really sorry.
So do you want to go upstairs and take a shower? Relax?
I'll just stay here. Relax and watch something. Just to calm my mind.
What did you do?
Well, I decided to help you out today. Sit, babe.
Wait. You cooked?
Yes, babe, I cooked. Well, it's just pop and fried plantain. Wait, babe. So I want you to relax, okay? I am not about to upset your taste bud. And don't forget, this is a thought that counts.
Okay. So can I dig in now?
Yes, you can dig in.
This doesn't look bad at all.
Really? Thank you.
Let's see this one. Babe.
Yeah.
This looks a bit watery.
Well, it's refused to get thinking like yours, babe.
That's because you must have used too much water while mixing the pap.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
How? You know, for some reason, I began to think that the pap was having something against me.
No, babe, but like you said, it's the thoughts that counts, babe.
Yeah.
I appreciate this. Thank you. Not bad.
Not bad?
No.
Babe, not bad is not what I had in mind when I was making this breakfast for my wife.
But you did a good job. Honestly, I'm impressed.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm glad you like it. You can see I'm sweating. I was nervous.
Did we just fry plantain? Why are you sweating?
It was not easy to fry plantain.
But you did a good job, babe.
I'm glad you like it.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. What are you doing here?
I came to help clean your apartment.
And what happened to the cleaners?
Well, one called in sick and the other cannot take on the duty alone, so I offered to help.
Ever so sweet and thoughtful. Come on in.
Thank you. So, where would you want me to start from?
You can start from anywhere you want.
Okay. How about the rooms?
That's fine. Okay, go ahead.
All right.
Coming. Oh, Are you done with the other rooms?
Yes, son. If you're busy, I could just go down and
No, I actually need to go downstairs to stretch my back. It's killing me.
You're beautiful.
I know, right? Thank you. I could make one for you if you want.
Sorry, I couldn't possibly afford you.
Are you being serious right now?
Yes.
So wait, you're telling me they don't pay you up to 100,000 for the supervising job you do here? Mm. You see? And it's even more than that. Come on. Happy scrubbing.
Thank you. Happy beating.
Yeah, I'm fine. The drugs are for my backache.
Can I?
Yeah, sure.
You know, I could teach you some exercises, routines. They could help with the back pain. You know, I used to take a lot of analgesics myself for back pain until someone introduced me to some daily routines that has helped.
Mm.
Yes. Besides, it's not advisable for you to be too dependent on drugs. They can be addictive.
Yeah, I know. And I'm getting used to these. I'm beginning to get worried.
Mm. So, are you interested in the exercise? They're not hard. I could just teach you some few easy tricks and you'll be left feeling good.
You make this sound like you're marketing a product.
Well, I am marketing the good life.
Okay, yes, I'm interested. When you're done, you can come show me. I can't wait to see this, your almighty technique to backache.
All right. So you place your hands here
on
the floor.
Like this?
Yes, mm-hmm. Right next to your heel. And then you raise your waist upwards.
Okay.
Stay there for a couple of seconds. And down.
Okay, this isn't as easy as I thought. Not at all.
It is. You should try it again.
Okay, let's try.
Alright, up.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
And
down.
Okay.
Yes.
But wow.
You stay for a couple of seconds.
No. This is not easy as I thought. So you've been this to help with my back? Oh, babe. You're welcome.
Am I interrupting anything?
No. Nothing serious. He was just helping me with some.
So shut up. Are you a fitness trainer? I thought you were the estate supervisor.
Babe, stop with the attitude.
Shut up. No, wait, don't you dare. Before you go, I need to ask you one question. How long has this rendezvous been going on between you and my wife?
Babe, you need to stop now.
See, I do not care what mystical powers you have. But I am not going to live in fear in my own marriage. You hear me? Now you listen. Listen to me. I don't want to ever see you anywhere close to my wife again. Do you hear me? See, let me tell you. You see that door? Huh? If you smell it, 10. If you see that door, 10. Even if it's 1 inch close to my wife!
That's small.
Because if I shut up, just 10, and don't get close.
All right. If you dare go close to her again, I swear to God, until we leave here, I will make sure that you will lose your job.
Sir, I just came.
I don't care what you came to do!
That's the one.
Watch it! Shut up! I don't freaking care what you came to do. See, if you smell that door, 10. If you see that door, 10. If you see my wife, if it's even 1 inch, do not ever in your life come close to her. I want you to get out of my house. Get out! Just get out!
That's the one.
This is what you want. Nonsense. This is what you want. You enjoy it. You're on the floor. You're on the floor. What the hell? What's the meaning of what you're doing?
I am giving you some space. I am leaving.
You better unpack those bags, okay? Listen to me. I lost my contract because of you. And your little demons destroyed my boss's laptop. Okay? And listen to me. You are going to sit in this house. And both of us are going to face the consequences, understood?
Whether you approve it or not, I am leaving this house, Desmond. Try to stop me.
Looks like I am not communicating my agitation enough. If you dare step out of this house, you are going to see the erratic side of the man that you married. See, this is my boss's laptop. The office! All the information's here helps in the afloat of the contract. And what did you do? You took it up on yourself to mess this up. Why didn't you just allow your demonic powers to affect something else? To mess up something else? And my boss's laptop?
My demonic powers, Desmond. Huh? Your career took a different turn after we met. You bought your first house and got your first international deal.
Point of correction. When we both got married, why is it that the bad stuff happens to me alone when the both of us have the altercations and then you get angry? But you were involved. I don't understand. Or is it that there is something the one party knows that the other party doesn't?
Desmond, if you continue like this, you'll end up in a mental home, you and your aunties.
Oh, my auntie, Abi.
Yes.
My auntie, Abi. Where are you now?
And I'm leaving. You can't stop me.
I am here. Okay?
Try to stop me.
Keep packing.
Try to stop me.
Just keep packing. Keep packing.
Madman.
Okay.
You're running mad.
I am mad, right?
Yes.
Desmond! See my mother!
Desmond! Okay.
See my mother. See. I'm here, okay?
I will leave, Desmond. Whether you approve it or not, I am leaving.
I thought I made myself clear enough.
If you dare come close to me, don't even try. Desmond! What do you think you're doing?
My friend, just go back inside!
I'm not going anywhere. I told you I'm leaving. I'm not going anywhere.
You're leaving.
If you dare touch me.
Then leave. Try it.
Okay.
Try me.
Desmond! Desmond! This is domestic violence! Let me go! I swear to God, I'll make sure you pay for this! Put me down! Madman! Put me down! Put me down, Desmond! No! Let me go!
You are not going anywhere! Remember what we say in the water, for better or for worse.
Desmond!
Oh, shut up!
Thoughts and energy, everything I did, I had it for you. You should know I love you every morning. Hope you don't see that I am broken. Yes, I'm a broken man. I woke up every morning trying to hide my flaws. It thought me into someone I don't recognize. I'm not a monster, I'm just broken and exhausted. Can't you see? Ooh, ooh, ooh. Somebody save me from bad energy. Somebody save me. Somebody save me. Somebody save me from bad energy. Somebody save me, somebody save me. I thought I was safe from these, I thought I was free from these. I'm a prisoner of my past. I thought I could be the one, I thought I could love you still. But it's obvious I still need some healing. So won't you stay, take my. Be the so would you stay, take mine and help me. I thought I was safe from this, I thought I was free from this. I'm a prisoner of my past. I thought I could love you still, I thought I could be the one. But it's obvious I still need some healing. So would you stay, take mine, be the one. So would you stay, take mine, and help me heal. Somebody save me from bad energy. Somebody save me. Somebody save me. Somebody save me from bad energy. Somebody save me. Somebody save me.
Somebody save me from bad energy. Somebody save me. It's me deeper than I thought. Messing with my thoughts and energy. Everything I did, I did for you. You should know I love you every morning. Hope you don't see that I am broken. Yes, I'm a broken man. I woke up every morning trying to hide my flaws. It thought me into someone I don't recognize. I'm not a monster, I'm just broken and exhausted. Can't you see?
I have abandoned my life, quit my job, so I can be with you, and this is how you choose to treat me?
Come on. Why don't you put your emotions aside and at least listen to what I want to say? Why do I get spunked when we both get angry?
Spunk for what, for goodness sake? Spunk for what exactly?
I don't know. And maybe you don't know too.
Maybe.
Yes, maybe, Emira. Yes. I literally feel like I'm living in a movie. Like a naive witch living in a movie. Where the naive witch blows up everything before realizing that she's done wrong.
I'm a naive witch.
Oh, Jesus. You something. See, I don't know what it is, but I am going to find an explanation to all this craziness. Because I made a promise to you. And you made a promise to me that we are going to do this for life. Please, eat this food and make me laugh. And I'm sorry that I locked you up in here. I just couldn't let you go. I haven't been able to do that ever since I set my eyes on you. And I'm not going to do that now, in spite of everything that is going on between us. I love you. Eat, please.
I was hoping if we could shift the date, ma.
Who do you think you are to think you can effect such big change? It is because I think your work is brilliant. There are better architects and engineers who are less clumsy.
I take responsibilities for the recklessness, ma.
You are taking responsibility for more than that. That's true. Because neither me nor my company will spend a little more than affair. That means whatever extra charges this stupidity of yours accrue will be taken care of by you. And as you reflect on this, let me quickly add that I have one single software in my company that costs me roughly 2.3 million naira to acquire.
Hello, ma, I've got...
what I'm about to say to you might sound a little strange.
Okay.
See, anytime my wife and I quarrel, I mean when we both get angry at each other, I get punished.
I don't understand.
Neither do I understand what's going on.
Can you be a little less cryptic?
Okay. If my wife and I quarrel this minute, the next minute, I am faced with misfortune. I mean, I would either hit my head on my way out or sprain my ankle, or my brake will almost fail. To think that I almost killed an innocent pregnant woman recently. Yes, bad stuff keeps happening to me. Just me.
This does really sound strange. Yeah. Have you discussed it with your wife?
Yes, I did. And she claims she has no idea what I'm talking about.
And you don't believe her?
I want to. She's my wife. I want to trust her.
Oh, buddy, I think you know exactly what you're talking about. But I have no idea.
See, this is why I need your help. Okay? I need to talk to someone. You know, I need someone to help me, like, figure out something, you know. Find someone who can, you know, figure out this clue or something. Like, speak to someone.
Breathe on. So won't you stay? Take mine and help me. I thought I was safe from these. I thought I was free from these. I'm a prisoner of my past. I thought I could love you still. I thought I could be the one. But it's obvious I still need some healing. So would you stay? Take my hands, be the one. So would you stay? Take my hands and help me heal.
Come on, I already apologize for locking you in here. I guess you're hungry. I could make dinner for you. Or better still, I could drive out and get you some food. I know what you want, so maybe I'd rather get that for you. Hey.
Why? Am I too pretty?
You don't look anything spiritual.
I should probably dress like a monk. Have my hair shaved. Is that what you think?
See, I don't know what my friend told you, yeah, but I don't want to waste your time, nor you waste my time either.
I can feel energy around you. Your wife. She is vibrating fearlessly. And you are burning too. You can't even protect yourself from your vibration, let alone I am an energy healer. I help people to fix their energy. And you, my boy, you're vibing too low.
I don't understand what you mean by your boy.
Number of years one spent on Earth is irrelevant in true dimension. I'm older than you because energy is so young and stupid. Letting vibration from outside foreshadow it.
See, first of all, I'm not gonna get angry because I am the one that needs your help,
Impressive. Pretty mature.
Regardless of everything, it looks like you know what you're talking about.
But I do. You are the one who is confused. Which is why you are paining finding answers.
How can you help?
How can you help yourself? We will start by cleansing the energy around this house. We will start by smoking this entire place. I will give you a smudge bundle, which includes a menta bowl, matches, tobacco, an eagle feather, and dry cedar. The first and important step is to set your intention on ridding your space from negative energies and vibes. Light up your candle and use the feather to fan out the fire Next, smudge your head for good thoughts. You do this by cupping a handful of the smoke and rubbing it on your head. Then smudge your eyes to see only the good in everything. Next, your mouth, so you speak only words of kindness. Then you can smudge the rest of the house by gently fanning the feathers over the smoke. Make sure it gets to all parts of the house to allow the smoke cleans everything that it touches. Don't forget positive thoughts, gratitude, and open spirit are what you need to convert the energy in your space to positive energy. No! The action is to help you reveal the particular emotion blocking your chakras. Only then can you handle the negative energy you and your wife create during arguments so it doesn't hurt you anymore. What did you see?
I saw myself doing the business. I will not do it another woman.
You don't trust your wife.
I trust her.
You want to trust her? But there is an unhealed trauma. Has kept you on the edge. What is it?
Just so we're clear, I invited you here to help me figure out why I cannot have a peaceful quarrel with my wife without mysteriously breaking a leg or experiencing any bad luck. And please, if you are not psychoanalyzing me,
when a husband and wife are vibrating on a different frequency, it corrupts the energy between them.
No, please don't generalize this whole thing, okay? I am the only one going through this in my marriage, me alone experiencing it, okay? But besides, I have not heard anyone complaining of such weird things.
Then your wife must be possessed or have some spiritual power.
Then that's a good thing. Because witchcraft is a thing, so it makes sense.
And so is vibration. Sometimes what we refer to others using witchcraft on us is our own negative vibration. Bouncing back.
I didn't want it to go away. I mean, all those negative vibrations, energy, whatever it is, I want them to go away.
First law of thermodynamics, energy is neither created nor destroyed. But can
how you as scientists do. Then if so, that's great. Maybe you can give me some scientific solutions to my mystery.
I can give you a crystal. Maybe an Epsom salt to clear the negative vibration. And then collect another 150,000 from you. Which we are to repeat every time you and your wife quarrel and transform the negative emotions into negative vibrations instead of using it on something positive.
But
there is a very simple solution. A mental exercise. It's what you need. What you go through people also go through it. Most are unaware.
See, I want to be unaware. Okay? I really want to be unaware. I want a normal life, a normal marriage, and a normal quarrel with a very normal wife. That's what I want.
Shame. Because we are all energies.
Can we talk, please? Please. I know I've been acting crazy lately. Right. I had a discussion with an energy healer. And then she confirmed that my bad luck is linked to energy we create anytime we fight.
Did she also confirm that I'm a witch?
No, come on, babe. I know that you are not a witch, okay? I was only frustrated because you didn't want to listen.
How can I listen when I'm being accused of something I know nothing about?
Babe, see, I know, okay? And now I will try to understand and not make assumptions.
You called me a witch, Desmond. You locked me up in our bedroom.
Because I didn't want you to leave me. Okay? Because if you leave me, my life will fall apart. You're my backbone. Okay? And you've been that for years.
I can't be your backbone and a harbinger of misfortune at the same time. Make up your mind.
Amy. You have been nothing but a blessing to me. You came into my life. And you lit up everything.
I'm tired. I miss you. I want you so badly, so badly. It's difficult going to bed without you in my arms.
And this vibe between us, this energy between us is driving me crazy. It's killing me. I feel like I'm buried. Please. Can we walk past this?
So what will you do about work?
Work will be fine. Hey. My boss.
Have you heard from the people fixing the laptop yet?
Hello, Ma.
Why are you not in the sites?
I have not been able to fix the laptop yet, Ma. Okay, Ma. I will be there shortly, Ma. What just happened?
She wants you back on site?
Yes, babe. Do you think that she threatened me on my job? Like, babe, looks like this vibration thing is really real.
Hey, don't start. I still can't wrap my head around it or figure out what you're saying. It doesn't make sense to me, but I'm down for whatever that makes us happy.
You are my pills and potion. Maybe, see, let me go and change with me before.
Okay.
If everything clears out of my bosses.
E for energy. Oh my God. Babe,
hey.
How did he go?
Very great, baby. Very great. And
good to have you.
Yeah, good to have you too. Sit down, see.
So how did it go? Tell me.
It was great. Super great, okay? My boss was pleased. And my laptop was fixed, so I'm picking up tomorrow.
Oh, that's a huge relief.
Yes, baby. You know, I realized that any time that we fight, I mean, like our vibe messes up, my life falls apart. Someone has to be in a good place. So I made a promise to myself that I'm gonna do right with all my heart. So I got you some.
Pain.
This for you, baby.
Really? Let's see. You know you shouldn't have.
No, I just I.
Okay. Oh wow, babe.
Do you like it?
This is beautiful. It's stunning.
You were stunning.
I love it. Thank you so much. You shouldn't have. You know that, right?
I'm with you too.
Thank you, babe. So what do you want first? Food or shower?
Oh, food or shower?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I select food. And then on the food, maybe I have some other options. So I select A. I want your food, baby.
Oh, so it has been naughty. Okay. What else do you want apart from my food? Thank you, babe. So, here, bring your hand. Oh, look at that.
Oh my God. This is beautiful, babe. This is beautiful, but why do you do this and just give it away? For peanuts. Okay, see, this is what we're going to do.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't we re-strategize? I mean, like, we get a PR team, we do some marketing, and then re-strategize your income plan.
Hey, bruh, I told you, I'll lose interest in this the moment it becomes something I'm making money off.
Then what is it?
Let's just say it's something I do to relax myself. Something I just do for relaxation. I have a career, remember?
Ah, yes. You have a career.
Look. I want you to remember, whenever you look at this, I want you to know that I chose you over everything. And no regrets.
I chose you for me too. There's no regret. No.
See,
oh,
wait. No, wait. Come help me with my back exercise downstairs. Let's go.
Okay.
Yeah, let's go. Be useful.
Yes, I will
be. I'm useful. Waiting.
I said, give me your password.
Why?
I said, give me the password to your phone.
No.
I'm not going to ask again. I said, give me the password to your phone.
It's your birthday.
Why is it that you delete messages between you and that object? Why would Dari text you to ask you if you're okay?
That's one. So this is the reason why you wanted to shout off the roof and bring down the house?
I will bring this house down! Okay? If you don't start explaining to me why a man would text my wife to ask her if she's okay.
Go to hell. I'm not doing this with you. Not today.
Hey, don't walk out of me. Now you start talking, woman. You better start talking.
I am not talking. I'm not saying anything to you until you're ready to talk and dialogue like a sane person and not shouting like a madman.
So now I am insane.
Eh? Yes, you're acting like
you. Now I'm insane. You made that guy, that thing, Dari or whatever his name is, text you to ask you if you're okay. If you are, to text, jeez. For real? For real? Nemrod, you're testing my patience. You are testing my patience. You better start talking now.
I'm not saying anything to you.
You're not saying anything. You're not saying anything, right? Okay,
you want to see
anything?
Yeah. Bring it on. I want to see your limits.
Do you want to see my limits?
Yes.
You want to see my limit. You want to see my limit. You want to see my limit, right? You want to see my limit, right? You see it. Okay. Oh!
I thought Honey helped you figure out things.
Well, she mentioned some things about vibration and energy and other bullshit, but I don't understand why I am the only one feeling the impact. Why is my wife not feeling what we created together?
Buddy, I wish I have answers to your questions. Just that, Honey helped me figure my vibrations out. She taught me how I was the one creating chores for myself. How I was the one letting the negative energy, the negative people into my life. So I think you should listen to her.
You know, there's this part of me that can't shake off the possibility of this minute more.
We all introduced to a world where we believe in sorcerers, demons, witches, heaven and hell. But I think there's more to it. And to figure out that, you have to reframe your perspective. You have to start seeing things like from the inside. That way you can reconnect to your energy and transform what is to be transformed.
Impressive. You have changed a lot.
That is what I've been trying to show you. Desmond, I know I really hurt you. I was a terrible girlfriend.
Well, what another bridge?
I'm really sorry for everything I made you go through in the past. I'm sorry.
It's a long time ago, and trust me, I moved past it.
Are you sure? Because Honey made me realize that the emotions, I mean the one I made you experience, doesn't go away that easily.
Oh, come on. Trust me, I'm not holding on to any emotions or anything. Trust me, all right? It's all good. And just drop it.
Okay, that's fine. Are you coming to the site today?
Yes, I'll be there in a bit. I just need to freshen up and... Anyway, thanks.
You're welcome.
Alright.
So, I'll see you at the site.
Sure, sure.
I wish you success in your marriage.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
I'm sorry.
What exactly are you suspecting me for, Desmond? That I'm cheating on you with Dari?
I don't know. Hey. I trust you. Okay? You're not the problem.
Then what is the problem? What is it? Because you fluctuate so fast, I can't even keep up anymore. What is the problem?
You're right. Rita was my ex.
What?
I was her first. I mean, we were each other's first. One day, I walked in on her with my cousin. I forgave her. Because I love her so much. And I felt responsible for her cheating on me with my cousin. Because I encouraged a relationship with him. She didn't want to be with me anymore. She wanted to be with him. And she is the reason I left Port Harcourt to Abuja. And she's the reason why I have serious trust issues.
Oh, babe, you know I would never do you like that. Never.
You'd know that you'd never treat me like that. But like I said, I'm the one messed up, babe.
No, babe, you're not. You're not. I wasn't fair to you either. I should have been more careful instead of putting you in the situation that triggers the memory.
Babe, I just want this memory gone. For good, forever.
You'll be late for work.
Doesn't even matter. I'm fucked. if I don't resolve this with you.
So, what now?
The last time you mentioned something about healing from a past experience.
True. Any form of unresolved issue can throw off your chakras and mess your energy.
Someone I loved and trusted betrayed me.
And now you are seeing everyone you love and trust through the lens of this betrayal.
I'm trying to let it go and trust again.
Was it a sexual relationship? All sexual relationships leave debris, particularly within people who do not practice any type of cleansing.
How do I practice cleansing?
I can teach you a few tricks and charge you exorbitant fee.
But you rather leave all the work for me?
Awareness is a gift. Seeing your energy and vibration playing a vital role in what is happening in your entire world places you in the mind of the Creator.
See, I don't want to be in the mind of the Creator. I want it to be normal.
When you have intimate relationship with someone, the two energies merge. If, let's say, you are vibing high and your partner tend to vibe low, they are probably sucking your energy through sex because they need it to make up for what you think you lost.
No, I am not sucking my wife's energy.
Like I said, the person you share your body with plays a huge part in how your energy is being affected. The more you interact intimately with your wife, the deeper the connection and the more her aura is intertwined with yours. In a plain and English, things will always get shitty for you whenever you both fight.
After I broke up with your cousin, I felt like committing suicide. Not because he dumped me, but because I realized I was a fool.
See, Rita, I went through an emotional roller coaster. It was crazy. It was bittersweet. It was vengeful. And I wish that you went through all the things that you made me suffer. But a part of me couldn't stop loving you because I thought that you were my soulmate. And I invested all of me in what we shared.
I'm really really sorry.
It's okay. You know, I think you leaving me helped me because I met my wife. And I realized that I was all wrong. Because you and I were never meant to be together. And that I was the only one seeing what wasn't there. You know, my wife gets me in so many ways, and I get it in so many ways too, but our bond is much more tuned and seamless. By seeing you again. Brought back flashbacks of the pain, the love, the hunger that it brought back everything. Worst of it, I kept lying to myself that what I felt for you was non-existent. And that affected the energy between my wife and I.
I'm truly sorry.
It's okay. Well, I see that you're at a happy place, and I'm happy for you. But I am not in a happy place. You know, the flashbacks keeps messing up with my headspace, and I cannot take it anymore. So I need to cut this tie between you physically and emotionally. Because anytime I see you, anytime I look at you, I see my wife through your eyes, and I don't want it anymore. This is what I've been dealing with for the past weeks. So I have decided to move to another estate.
How about work?
I can manage that. I mean, I want to be 100% committed to what's happening in my marriage.
I understand. She's a lucky woman.
No, I am the lucky one. Ever happened to me. I am sorry I acted the way I did. It's just because of my past experiences, but I promise that I'll let go of that energy because I'm vibing with your vibrations.
You know I love you, right?
I love you. I love you more than you love me.
No, no. I love you more.
No, I love you more than you love me.
No.
No, my love is bigger.
No.
My love is bigger.
That's not true. I love you more.
Till we die.
Mm-hmm. Till we die. Insanity and in
madness.
It's me deeper than I thought. Messing with my thoughts and energy. Everything I did, I had it for. You should know I love you every morning. Hope you don't see that I am broken. Yes, I'm a broken man. I woke up every morning trying to hide my flaws. If I'm mean to someone I don't recognize, I'm not a monster, I'm just broken and exhausted. Can't you see? Somebody save me. I thought I was safe.
a prisoner of my past. I thought I could be the one. I thought I could love you still. But it's obvious I still need some healing. So won't you stay? Take my hand. Be the So won't you stay, take mine and help me. I thought I was safe from this, I thought I was free from this. I'm a prisoner of my past. I thought I could love you still, I thought I could be the one. But it's obvious I still need some healing. So would you stay, take my